Hi everyone, my name is Vivek and this is the first episode to create to-do list using Vue JS. If you are new to my channel, then please don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon so you never miss out my new tutorials. So to begin the course, you can open my GitHub account and I have provided this link in the description below. Once you are in this repository, you should see two folders over here, End and Start. You can use this End folder if you want to see the end result of our app, which is this one. But if you want to follow along with me, then you can use this Start folder. Now let's clone this repository, so click on Code and copy this link. Then on desktop, you can create a new folder. You can call it Vue.js. Then you can open this folder in your text editor. In my case, I'm using Visual Studio Code. Then you can open the terminal. So click on Vue and click on Terminal. Now to clone the project, you can type git clone and you can paste the link that you have copied. Navigate to the start folder, so you can use cd vue and then cd start. Then to install the node module, you can run npm install. To run the project, you can use npm run serve. You can then press Ctrl key and click on this link to view the project. And you should see some static content. Great. Now, let's quickly check the code before checking the demo. So open your text editor, click on source, and we got our main app, which is app.vue. So here we have added a child component, tux, which is imported from this components folder. And at the bottom, we have some sample data with ID, title, and completed status. In our tux component, we have all our static HTML code. We will work mostly on this component, plus we will create one more child component in the future. All styles are added under this main.js, which is importing main.css from assets and CSS folder. Now, let's quickly check the demo and then we'll wrap up this course by adding one new tux item to make sure everything is good to proceed. So this is the demo of our app, which we will be working in our upcoming session. Here you can create new tux. Read book, for example. You can remove the tux which is completed. You can complete new tux. You can see how many tux are pending. So currently we have two tux pending, which is go shopping and read book. You can clear the completed tux. And finally, you can clear all of these tux. Now, before I wrap up this course, let's add one more tux item to check everything is fine. So open your text component. You can then copy this li, add some text item. I will call it readbook. You can then check your site and you should see a new text item over here. Great. It seems everything is good to go. This is the end of this session. In the next session, we'll pass the data from parent to child component using props, and we will also work on this clear all button. Feel free to comment below if you have any questions. Also, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel to get more videos in the future. Thank you and see you soon.